Hey everyone, welcome to round two. Our opponent won the roll and chosen to play first, and he's keeping his hand. Our hand's fine, so we're not gonna mull. One forest and one swamp, and this hand's pretty sweet, I think. And there's the swamp, so we'll go ahead and lead off with that. And we're on our way to curving out. Let's see if we can actually play a sweet game. Thraven Heretic. All right, so we're gonna want to trade that off as quickly as possible because it's pretty good against our deck. We've got Vorpeed and Spider Spawning. I don't know if he'll want to end up doing that, so we'll probably have to use this Walking Corpse to do so. Let's see. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and play our Forest Bash in, and then we can probably play. Yeah, all right. It looks like he's going to want to trade. I'm fine with that. We'll play Ghoul, and then we can play Moan next turn and then use Spidery Grass to kill a flyer. And he's got nothing, so got the test subject. That's kind of annoying. So we're gonna go ahead and see if he blocks. Yeah, he's probably blocking. Yeah, I don't really care about using Spidery Grass now. I'd rather cast Moan and then worry about the test subject in a little bit. Rolling Temblor. Okay. Well, that wasn't bad. Forest. Ooh, there we go. So, this guy's on something. This is weird. Sturmgeist. Well, now that's pretty good in itself. So, we're gonna go ahead and see what we draw. Juggernaut. That's not as great. Think what we're just gonna do is start off by bashing. Then we can play a Juggernaut or a Screeching Bat or Spider Spawning. If we spawn for two, that's kind of weak. Yeah, it's actually not that bad. He can flashback Rolling Temblor potentially if he has a mountain, but I think it's more likely that he's splashing red and is not going to be able to do that very easily. Casting Bat now is pretty weak since I would generally want to cast it in the same turn we cast Spidery Grasp. So I think casting Spawning now is fine. And let's see what he has. Hopefully it's not a mountain. Because if he attacks with the Sturmgeist, then we can just chomp and then that'll be good. Yeah, so we're gonna go ahead and block. And I guess we're racing test subject now. Oh. He had the Rolling Temblor. That's interesting. Fortress Grab. Okie dokie. Well, that's definitely something. Yeah, so we're just gonna go ahead and attack with that. And I feel like attacking with or using Spider Grass now is going to be not the best thing that we could do. And we can play Hollow Henge Guardian, and that's effectively doing the same thing. I mean, we're clearing the path, and but this way we're actually going to be able to keep the Spider Grasp to kill the Sturmgeist with. So now, okay, we're going to trade off our token again. And be content with attacking with a bunch of huge guys. He's going to be able to level the test subject up. So that sucks. So we're gonna have to. We just need to draw land. That's his plan. So we're gonna go ahead and attack again. Feeling of Dread. So if he plays, let's see. We're just gonna go ahead and play the bat then, I guess. He can level, then level again. And he can attack for a bunch, and that Feeling of Dread is going to make it so that between that and Rolling Temblor, he's going to be able to hit hit for a bunch of damage. So I think I'm just gonna go with casting the bat. And because we have a few outs that we can draw, and this is gonna take a lot of his mana, so I'm more inclined to try and win that way. And so he's attacking, so now I think we're gonna go ahead and kill this guy off. Let's see if he has any removal for this. Nope. Alright. And so he can level up his test subject. And force through a bunch of damage, but we'll see if he goes to cast anything. I imagine he's just going to leave up four lands and pass the turn. Yeah. So there's a Silver Chase Fox, so he's going to make a big guy. And let's see, we really don't have anything. I mean, we can transform now. Or we can just draw something and or play the Juggernaut. Playing the Juggernaut here is going to be pretty bad, I think, just because he has the feeling of dread, and so I'd rather play it. I'd rather just transform this than let him feeling of dread than play Galvanic Juggernaut. So that it just puts him in the position where he has the feeling of dread. So we can, and then we could play a bunch of enough power so that he can't actually attack. Let's see, so that doesn't get back anything. So we're going to go ahead and attack with, we can level up our guy, but that's not really going to do anything, so I'm not going to bother attacking. And we'll just let him transform and then do his worst. Yeah, this is where we can draw some removal, ideally. And he's got that Rolling Tumbler in the graveyard still, so we've got Moan. Let's see what he's got. Requiem Angel. That's pretty good. So we're going to go ahead and hopefully draw something. An Uvenwald Mystics. So that doesn't do anything. I think we're going to go ahead and cycle this Grave Purge and hopefully draw a, if we draw a Victim of the Night, we'll be in some pretty sweet shape. Or we can draw land and then play whatever. But here we're just going to go ahead and play Hamlet Captain because we've got nothing better to do. And we'll let him start bashing us to death with the Angel. So this guy's deck is something. He's got, I wonder what else he's splashing for. Can't imagine Rolling Tumbler is the only card. That just seems a little mediocre. So it looks like he's going to he's sort of forcing our hand here. So we're just going to go ahead and block with everything, I guess. What does that do? Let's see. So if he has Moment of Heroism, then we end up taking one like this. So, yeah, otherwise, I mean, the only reason they would cards that would explain this would be Moment of Heroism or Break the Day or Skillful Lunge, some sort of pump effect like that. Spare from Evil. And so we can throw in the Hamlet Captain, but that doesn't really, if he has Skillful Lunge, then I think that, it's basically we're taking 1 point of damage extra if we don't block with the Hamlet Captain, although it's one more that he gets to kill. So I think I'm fine with that. I don't think that one damage is going to end up mattering too much. And our War Period comes back as a 6 power guy, which can attack through the Fortress Crab. Hmm. So he didn't kill that off. He's got Moreland Hunt. So he's going to try and grind us out that way. So what I think I'm going to do, let's see, he's got Test Subjects, Sturmgeist, Heretic, so he can make a bunch of guys, and we really, so we need to flashback spider spawning for him to do anything. So we that'll take his Rolling Temblor. So we're going to go ahead and just attack with these guys and see what he does. 2, 3, 4. We got four guys. That's not enough to kill the angel, unfortunately. And there's a sea skite. Okay, well, that's also interesting. And this fortress crab has been a beating. Alright, so well, we get one more guy, but he's gonna Temblor, and then we're gonna be dead after that. So I don't really, s but we don't really have an alternative. So let's go ahead and flashback grave or spider spawning. And then hopefully he doesn't see it. Three color Moreland Hunt, man. I wish I were that lucky. Yep, there's Temblor. He gets a guy. So we're basically just dead here. Getting hit for 9. And we draw not what we need. Alright. So we can do some boarding. Alright, so we've got a bunch of stuff that we can actually board out. I don't really like Slayer of the Wicked against red, white, blue. We haven't really seen too many cards that he has that Slayer is good against. We can board in Crushing Vines, which is pretty sweet. He's got stuff like Sturmgeist and Requiem Angel. And so I also want to board in Night Terrors. And so the last card is actually somewhat interesting. We can board in an 18th land because our mana curve is pretty high. Or we can board in Maw of the Mire and board out another creature or something like that. And I mean, Maw of the Mire deals with something like deals with his blah 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 blah, his Moreland Hunt. But I think I'm just gonna board in two lands. I'm gonna board in. I think the 18th land is something that we're gonna be interested in. And so we'll keep it like that.